Hi, my name's Tristan, and these are the Kawaguchi Lectures. On Sunday the 14th, 2019, I was lucky enough to be present at a series of lectures that Mr. Kawaguchi gave at the Australian leg of the Gundam Builders World Cup. These lectures were unique from the point of view that they've only ever been delivered once in public, and this was in Osaka, Japan, I believe it was earlier this year. They have never been delivered, heard, or viewed in the English-speaking world. With the help of Lincoln Wright, who is the brains and face behind Paint and Plastic and is also a 25-year veteran of the Japanese modelling industry, we are now very lucky to be able to have these lectures. As I said, have never been heard of outside of Japan, and they've only occurred once before. Thanks to Lincoln, we're actually able to get a translation into modellers' language and able to gain some insight into the way Mr. Kawaguchi does stuff. We were privileged enough to be able to hear him speak quite passionately about one of his favourite topics, which is using the Gundam story to influence your Gunpla building, alongside getting an insider's point of view of the judging process at the finals of the Gundam Builders World Cup. These lectures are unique from the point of view that at these conventions, he usually just delivers workshop-style demonstrations, which is him showing people how to paint or how to scribe, etc. We don't actually get to hear him talk through a process and show and share the love that he has for this property that he's been involved with since day one. It's now celebrating 40 years. So, you know, he is, as we all know, the face of Gundam, but I don't think a lot of people understand his actual role and involvement in the property. So to be able to actually listen to him talk about this stuff as opposed to showing us how to do things was a very unique experience. Given that these two talks went for well over an hour, I've split them up into their natural breaking points just to allow for easier access for viewing. Because if you're like me, trying to sit down and digest something that's like 60 plus minutes is actually quite difficult. So I've split them up into 4 to 5 parts each at natural break points in the talks, focusing on a specific topic that was in that section of the talk. I do apologize in advance. The noise, sound quality, I've done the best that I can. I am not a sound engineer. I've isolated and boosted the volume and the audio as much as I can. But unfortunately, there is a bit of noise in the background because it is filmed at a convention. In one of the talks, there's like a trumpet playing some anime theme for a couple of minutes, which does get a little bit annoying, but you can still hear the audio quite well. So I do apologize in advance. Remember, I'm not a professional film sound person. I'm just a guy with a camera who's sitting in the front row. Please enjoy these videos. I'm really hoping that they're of help to you. And it was my pleasure to be able to record them and edit them. Again, I do apologize for the sound quality. I've done the best that I can. I'm not a professional. So please enjoy.
Okay. Does anybody not know what this wonderful gentleman has brought us? Basically, we're here because Kawaguchi-san made Gunpla. Thank you so much, Kawaguchi-san. And isn't he just the best guy? He's so humble, but yes, it's a really big thing. And today he's going to do a special show that's usually only in Japan. That's my fault, right? Kawaguchi-san said, well, I've got a friend there in Australia who can help me bring the Japan-level show that's usually only there, and we'll do it in Australia. And, I mean, we can't say it's his favourite show, but you like the Australian show very much, right, Kawaguchi-san? Yes. So he likes the show. So we'll let him get started. So previously we've just heard a wonderful discussion from Aaron on the Builders Cup from the view of a builder, somebody participating.
私の方からはやっぱ同じGBWCの話をしようと思ってるんです。
So I'm going to do a very similar discussion, but I'm going to do it from the perspective, of course, of somebody who's judging. なので、まあ、GBW 本体が、今年で9回目になるんですけども、GBW そのものの、どういうイベントなのかっていうのも含めて、
And Kawaguchi, someone would like to do a very brief explanation of what the year of Gunpla Builders World Cup can be for us in
2019.
So what this title is, that this is the year, the 2019 is the year for the 40th anniversary of Gunpla. Actually, that's pretty cool, right?
40 years.
Sorry, I got really scared when I see this. I'm scared to explain all of that at once, right? But this is a digest of some of the things that Kawaguchi-san would like to share with us. So, of course you know about Gunpla overseas, but Gunpla was born in Japan in
1980.
So, from our eyes, both of us, all of you guys look quite young, so that was quite a long time ago. So at that time, it was very quickly took off in overseas countries in Hong Kong, for example, and Thailand,
Taiwan.
So of course, Kawaguchi-san considers that the Japan market is not so big, so of course it's advantageous to go to overseas. So, the first real expansion into Asia happened around 1990.
Gundam Wing.
Gundam Wing.
Wing.
Ah, Wing. Wing. Color.
で、ウィングが、映像と、プロダクツを、一緒にもう海外に出していこうっていうふうに、サンライズと一緒にやってったんですよね。
So it was planned to do overseas expansion with the Gundam Wing property.
だから、まあ、海外の方々で、自分にとってのファーストガンダムはガンダムウィングだっていう人はすごく多いです。
いますよね。はい。So lots of people from overseas have said to Kawaguchi-san that that was the first Gundam they saw, Gundam Wing. Yes, we hear it all the time, right?
で、そこから、本格的に海外でも展開を始めていって、で、2000年になってくると今度ガンダムシードがあったり、その後、SD 三国伝。っていうような、海外でも楽しんでいただけるようなコンテンツっていうのがどんどん出てきたんですね。
Okay, and then over expansion series happened in 2000 with Seed Property, as you guys would know, and in 2010, SD Gundam. I said, you guys all know SD Gundam, we had a special event for it.
で、この頃に、まあ、2010年ぐらいに、SD Gundam の三国伝っていうのをやって、で特にあの三国志っていうのは要は中国の古典ですよね、はい、だから今でもずっと、まあ、新しいシリーズも始まりましたけども、今でもやっぱりずっと、三国志好きですよっていう、特に中国系の方はとても多いのが実際です。
三国伝、いつも僕はそれ覚えにくいからごめんなさいね。三国伝って It's a, so that one's based on a Chinese property, and that one has actually been very popular with people of an ethnic Chinese background, and it's still continuing to be popular, so they're supporting it.
で、今、今回皆さん参加していただいているのがガンプラビルダーズワールドカップというのがあるんですけども、その前に、アジアカップというのがありました。ご存知の方、もしくは参加された方もいらっしゃるかもしれませんけども、2003年に、バンダイアクションキットアジアカップっていうのが
始まったんですね。覚えてます。でこれっていうのは、そういったガンダムウィングの頃から、各国でガンプラを、みんなに知ってもらおうっていうことで、じゃコンテストをやるとやっぱりそこでみんな注目してくれる。でそれまでは各国バラバラでやったんです。
So, as you guys know now, we have the competition called GBWZ. But for those of you who've been in the game for a long time, you will remember the, how do we pronounce that? How do we say it in English, Tristan? You remember.
Backpack and backcook.
Very good, thank you. Did you guys hear it? Backpack and backcook. So, and they were, of course, Bandai's plans originally to help the property grow into surrounding countries in Asia. You can see on the list there we've got China, Korea, Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia, Thailand, Kankoku, is Korea, and the Philippines.
I can't read it.
素晴らしい。最初のも本当に 1,2,3,4,5,6 カ国で始まったんですけども、その後韓国、フィリピンが加わって、でその後。
Sorry. So it was the six countries originally. I messed up and I went to the additional countries that were expanded to in 2005.
Seven in the beginning. And then,
so seven from the beginning and then they expanded from there in 2009.
Hi.で、その後、今度、イタリア、北米、今度オーストラリアも参加してくれるようになって、で、アジアカップじゃないよね。で、じゃあユニバーサルカップにしようと。
So the name changed, of course, because they started to expand outside of Asia. First going to Italy in 2006, then America in 2007, and then finally came to Australia in 2010. Thank you very much.
で、オーストラリアが参加してくれて、それを12カ国まで増えたんです
よ。 So, including Australia, it went to a total of 12 countries that were competing.
で、それが、まあ、バクっていうね。
バク、うんうん。
で、その後、まあ、どんどん広がっていく中で、やっぱり日本が参加して、本当にワールドカップっていう形でやっていこうよっていうことで始まったのが2011年。
And then because of the continuous expansion and success of these competitions and the popularity, in 2011 Japan expanded the title and called it, we could have a World Cup in Japan. And that's the Gunpla Builders World Cup that we know now.
で、GBWC になってから、まあ、12の国とエリアね、で、スタートしたんですけども、まあこれタイが最初の年に水害があって参加できなかったので12になるんですけども、まあ基本的に13のスタートの、で2017年の去年の前の年ねに、その前のバカ君の時には北米っていうことでエリアを見せたんですけども、それをアメリカとカナダで分けてそれぞれにエントリーしてもらうような。それからあとフランスとベトナムも一昨年参加してもらうようになって、全部で16エリアになっています。
だからです。 So with the expansion period from 2011,it started with a total of 12 countries. Thailand wasn't included for the first year. Then from 2012, Thailand came back in. Then through further expansion, 2017,Gunpla Builders World Cup had expanded to a total of 16areas. It was also because they split. Instead of just having a North American competition, Canada got their own show.
で、まあ、ちょっとこれ日本語で本当申し訳ないんですけども、各国の受賞国なんですよ。で、これはね、また改めてね、英語版にして、そうだな、SNS なんかで、ご覧いただけるようにしようと思ってます。
So,our apologies that this is all in Japanese, but Kawaguchi-san has a plan to have this translated into English for us and then distributed through social media.
で、まあ、日本語わかる方だと、いろんな国が、入賞して、1位になってるんですよ。だから日本が参加してからの、GBWC でも、じゃあ日本がずっと取ってるかというとそんなことはなくて、インドネシアであるとかマレーシアであるとか、いろんな国がやっぱり、世界一になっているのが今実際です。
And one of the reasons for sharing this information is because somehow there seems to be an expectation, almost an idea, that Japan is always winning this. But through this this chart, we can see that actually there's been our world champions. It's been won all over the world. Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines, Korea. Yeah, it's big.